This is Jackie, and I'm here with Islander for your all-access interview here at Rock on the Range. Day one of Rock on the Range, the weather is still holding up. So what are some rock or metal artists that you grew up listening to?
Bad Brains, POD, Zayo. There's a lot, I don't know. MXPX, Converge.
You're from South Carolina as well, right?
I'm not, actually.
You're not? Where are you from?
I'm from Arizona.
Okay, so in Arizona, what were some good rock radio stations that you make sure you tune to?
I mean, KUPD is the biggest one there. I mean, I love freaking Story of the Year. I don't even know. There's so many bands I like. It's like whenever we do an interview, I go blank. I'm like, what are their names again? No, there's so many.
Well, we'll talk about your music instead. You should be the experts on that, right? Describe your latest album, Violence and Destruction, for new fans.
Our album, Violence and Destruction, is our debut record. It's done really well on the charts, thanks to you guys. And, it's a heavy record. It's got a lot of abrasive moments, but it's also very, we like to call, catchy. I grew up listening to Depeche Mode and Joy Division and stuff like that. So that world of New Wave kind of heavily influenced me with choruses and stuff like that. So, we're just a heavy rock band that really just wants to do the best that we can. That's what it comes down to.
So is there one song on the album that best represents your sound?
I don't know. They're all different.
What's one of your favorites?
My favorite is probably, I think, Hearts Grow Cold. I love that song.
What's your favorite on the album?
On the album? Because the live show's a little different, you know what I mean? But on the album, the one that always kind of hit me the hardest was New Wave.
So
New Wave music.
There you go. So talk about your live shows. What can fans expect?
Just to be piling all over each other, jumping around, yelling to the top of their lungs, remembering that there's freedom, you know, for that moment, and their boss isn't there breathing down their neck, unless their boss is there breathing down their neck and wants to have fun and brought them to a rock show. So,
which would be really cool.
Yeah, so if your boss is there breathing down your neck and he took you to the rock show, how rad. But if your boss isn't there breathing down your neck, you know, as well, remember, we're here to have fun, be safe, we'll take care of the crowd the best we can, but it comes down to them doing it, so.
And we're here at a festival, but you guys normally play smaller shows. Which do you prefer, the bigger festivals?
It's hard to say. I mean, I love the club shows because they're really intimate. But at the same time, I think we make it a point to make it intimate no matter what. So even the big festivals, like he's going out there in the crowd and stuff. So I'd say the big festivals for me.
Make sure you leave your mark.
Yeah, it's like any show. I always tell people, you know, it's not about how big the crowd is. I mean, I've played in front of 1,000 people and they've been weak. Played in front of 20 people and they've been nuts. So it's all about the fans. We can get on stage and go crazy, but until they bring it, you know, they're the rock show. It's just practice until they're ready to have a show. We try to make it about them and let them know this isn't about us being on stage. It's about you guys. So that's
it. One thing that gets me about shows, no matter big or small, is a lot of kids are on their phones. I kind of want them just to, like, grab a quick picture. Yeah, I don't want to watch a show through somebody else's phone screen. Yeah. What do you guys do to use technology to reach fans when you're not on stage?
I mean, social media, that's, like, a big thing for us. We like to stay connected with people, and it's actually us, not just someone running the page. Yeah. So, you know, again, like we said, the fans are the number one thing for us. So anything we can do to give back. So.
What social media platform do you like best?
I'm very visual, so I like Instagram.
What about you?
Same. Yep.
That seems to be a common thing, especially with bands. I don't know if it's because there's the visual and the audio.
Everyone loves pictures. I mean, you see a picture, especially like we'll see friends from other bands, and people are like, oh my gosh, they're together in one picture, you know? So it's really cool.
Well said.
Like, even people that, like, you know, I've seen kids, people used to always want people's autographs, and we still do those. People ask for them. But it's the kind of thing where you see more people wanting, like, I want a picture with you because it proves to my friends that I, you know what I mean? So
yeah, because some of you guys, your autographs are, you know, you can't tell. I need real proof. A photo's real proof.
Yeah, I think with typing over the years, our handwriting's gone downhill.
Oh, God, that's such a bad excuse, but it's probably true. So what's up next for you guys after Rock on the Range?
We're going out with 10 Years and Star Set in June, and then we're doing a direct support tour with POD. We're excited. Those are some good friends of ours. There's going to be two really good runs. We're excited.
Very nice.
Well, some headline stuff after that.
Ooh, nice tease. Well, stay tuned for a lot more from Islander. This is Jackie, thanks to All Access, and In the Key of Change. And I am going to grab a picture of you.